A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Inshallah, we'll be talking about today some verses from Quran which are considered as scientific miracles, and also there are some people on YouTube and on lots of many websites that they are claiming that these verses they are not miraculous, it's like all rubbish. And so one of them is this guy called Rationalizer, and also many Christians and other enemies of Islam, as well as Muslims. There are also many Muslims who are like misinterpreting these verses and trying to make a Quran like a science book. First of all, we need to realize something, that the Quran is sent to all the human beings, and individually everyone should have the ability to understand lots of verses in the Quran without referring to any tafsir. So in that sense it is simple, but in other sense it might be complex, so you may need a teacher, and, but these teachers should be qualified enough. So some of the prerequisites of this qualified individual is, first of all, you need to know classical Arabic, and you have to be a master on this. We are not talking about like if you can speak Arabic or not, because many Arabs can speak Arabic, but they will not be able to understand the Quran, and they will even misunderstand Quran, what it is saying. And so, because this is like talking about, like in English language, if we talk about like a Shakespeare in English, not many people will understand his proses. So you need to like some sort of have a good level of English, and then maybe with the help of some commentary, etc., then you will understand better. And the Quran is a book which has been, it is unique in the sense that I give this example of how DNA is kept inside the nucleus. That it is, if you, let's say, if you stretch the molecules of DNA, and it will, like, let's take the genome of a human being, and if you stretch it, it's gonna go from here to the moon, kind of thing, for 15 times. So, but it is, it's been like preserved in a very like confined space inside the nucleus in a cell. For example, DNA, and if you, let's say, you know, stretch that bit, then that is gonna be also like really long. So, Quran, the verses, they need commentaries. And for that, you need to definitely master Arabic language. It is going to be classical, as well as something called like Aymul Balagha, and this is like eloquency in Arabic language. There are other sciences under the name of Aymul Balagha, which, for example, like Aymul Bayan or Badi'a and Ma'ani and these sort of things. And not only that, you need to also know like Hadith. But not only hadith, you need to know the understanding of the hadith. Because not every muhadith can understand all the hadith. So this is also another thing. Also, you need to know something called the usul. These are like principles of the religion. And then you will have some sort of like background. Oh, I forgot to mention also, you have to definitely memorize the Quran, not only the Quran that we are reading right now, according to Imam Hafiz and Asim, but also different types of Quran. So, like we have 10 of them. So you have to know all these things, so that you know you can talk about a verse as a teacher. But nowadays we have like many people. They talk about like these verses, they don't even know what they mean. seriously. It's just a joke, so that's why we are doing this lecture. And they don't even know the word, they can't even pronounce the word, it's that bad. So it's and so this guy, I saw the movie of this clip, he's claiming that Muslims believe that the earth is flat. And yes?
It's a bit of a rationalizer.
Yes, yeah. There are also other people, especially Christian websites, just to show that Islam is a religion which doesn't make sense, etc. The first thing is, there's not a single verse in Quran which says that the earth is flat. Secondly, Quran is not a geography book that is gonna talk about the formation, the shape of the earth, and this happened and that happened, or any book which is about physics or mathematics. So people have this misunderstanding that I'm gonna read this verse and then I'm gonna find something about science. Complete rubbish. The Quran's message is clear. It is to show that there's one God only, and the last messenger is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we believe in all the prophets, including Jesus, Moses, from Adam. And we are here for a purpose. We will die. It talks about Day of Judgment, for example, and then there's hellfire, there's paradise. So it's talking about we are here ephemerally. This is a temporary world. So that's why this is the message of Quran. There's one God only. God doesn't have any sons or mothers, or doesn't have any family. Okay? So the Quran, there's no purpose of Allah talking about I made the earth oblate, spheroid, but it's a bit flattened through the poles, and it accelerates at this speed. So do you understand? But you see people, they go and they find things from Quran, and then they multiply numbers, they take words, mix them, and then try to come up with something. Why? Because they want to be famous. So this is a disease in these people's heart. And so how do you remove this disease? You need to practice Islam. And the best way of removing these illnesses, for example, is through tasawwuf. If you neglect tasawwuf, then you will never achieve this. You will always have these diseases in your heart. And so there's not a single scholar of Islam who reject tasawwuf. There's not a single one. Even those who are against Sufis, etc., they accept tasawwuf. But there might be some Sufis, some Muslims, they might be deviant. You can reject them. Okay, so that's fine. So, but this tasawwuf is important, because if you don't know what tasawwuf is, then you will not be able to, or the sciences of tasawwuf, you will not be able to treat your inner vices. The showing off, that feeling that you want to show off to people. You want to I heard people there saying I want to memorize this hadith so I can sip it out, at people's face, and prove my point. And you see people, they go to conferences, or they listen to people on TV, and then they say for example, this verse is talking about the scientific miracle, that verse is talking about the scientific miracle. And the congregation, they know nothing, right? So they're ignorant. They're like a football match. And the guy is mostly showing off. So he may say, this hadith says that it's so, because there's no spiritual sincerity there. It's just showing off. He himself doesn't even know what the verse is talking about. So that's why they can come up with rubbish. For example, taking the verse in Surah Al-Anbiya, This is a very famous one. Surah Al-Anbiya is chapter 21, verse 30. Okay, and this one talks about the As'ana Bismillah. أَوَلَمْ يَرَى الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَنَّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ كَانَتَا رَتْقًا فَفَتَقْنَاهُمَا وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيٍّ أَفَلَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. So here, clearly, like it says, أَوَلَمْ يَرَى الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Don't these disbelievers, don't they see? So here, the word yara can be used in two main meanings, let's say. One is like you can see with your own eyes, and the other one is like don't they think as well? Like don't they like contemplate over this? And so kafaru, disbelievers, like those people who don't believe. So anna samawat, so it talking about like a samawat. Samawat is the plural of sama. Okay, so this sama means actually canopy. And this is like one of the things, for example, this guy, like Rationalizer, he says he considers himself and he thinks that other people, this is like his assumption, he's assuming that other people also think that canopy is always flat. Like if I ask you guys like just simple question, canopy or any kind of ceiling, does it always flat? Like, does it always, is it always flat? Like, do you call it always, like, flat, canopy? No. One example, for example, let's talk about the canopy of, I don't know if you ever, like, visited a jet aircraft. Hmm. You know, those, like, fighter jets or those ones, you know, for weather forecasting, you know, they go up this way. So you will see, you know, some of them, like, they have, like, writings on the plane, just next to the canopy of the plane. Because that plane, jet, has a canopy, which, like, you sit, it is, like, linked to the cockpit. So, for example, if something happens, God forbid, in the air, you can just push the button and then it can release you. So that transparent canopy, like it's your ceiling, that one. So if you, for example, if you lift that, it's raised, you raise the canopy, okay? This is just, so what is that canopy, is that flat? And there, in the writings, you will see like some warnings. It says, if the canopy, you know, doesn't, like work or something like that, yeah? So attention kind of thing. Mm-hmm. So they call it canopy. It's canopy of that jet aircraft, right? So and it is a transparent canopy. Everyone can see it. If you guys watched like a movie like Top Gun, yeah? So you will see that canopy there. Yeah? There is a canopy. It is not flat. This guy assumes that that is flat. Also, canopy is like ceiling. Okay, so it is a ceiling. So sama is ceiling. So now the question, do ceilings, do they exist on top of things or at the bottom? Simple question.
On top and top.
Exactly. So we know that ceilings, do all ceilings come as flat?
No.
So this guy is first like assuming that canopies are flat. Muslims think that canopies are flat. Yeah? You see how he is like misleading people deliberately? Because he has a purpose. He just wants to like deviate or deceive, you know? Like deceive people. He wants to lead people astray. And so he is not sincere, it is so obvious. Because if he was a sincere person, he would just you know, talk to people, ask them what, you know, these things mean, etc. And all he quote from the translations. So he reads an English translation, and then he sees there the word canopy, and then he defines that word with his own like thinking. extremely biased. And what we said at the beginning, in order to like explain a verse like a teacher, you need to know, you need to master Arabic language. I don't know like how many Arab people exist on the planet right now yet, but like I'm saying 99% of them will not be able to explain this. Because they do not have the ability. Because in order to learn that, you need to go through certain stages. So, this is like, you know, saying that there is a town where in this town, all the adults are scientists of some kind. Let's say everyone is physicists. And then you are seeing just a newborn baby, just innately becomes physicist as well. That's what you are claiming. Like, and Muslims are claiming this as well. It's just so stupid. It is, and that's why, you know, one of the things that we are in this mess is because of this. Everyone thinks, because they can read and write, that they are like scholars. Including, you know, those people you see on like Islam channel and, you know, YouTube, this, that, everywhere. So one of the people, for example, I will mention is Bilal Flips. This guy, he says E equals MC squared is shirk. Okay? You can read it. It is like someone brought it to me and asked me, because I'm a theoretical physicist, and when I see that, I'm just gobsmacked. I'm thinking like, what is this? Yeah? And then his reasoning is, because E equals MC squared, he does, I'm sure he doesn't know how this equation, yeah, formula, drive. He has no clue. Because the formula is not that. That is like a formula for a, let's say, you know, particle at rest. But for a particle which is moving, yeah, that formula is not, is completely different. And that formula has got lots of implications and more to it. You know, lots of people like Schrodinger, Dirac, yeah, these sort of like great like scientists worked on certain equations to drive or to help, like for example, that equation to flourish, and then we can understand the certain concepts of physics. And this guy is just coming and saying that this is shit. So people who believe in this equation as truth, yeah, and they are being all mushrik. You see, if you say that this is shirk, and then people who believe that this equation is true, they are being mushrik. Yeah, many Muslims are now like who believe in this equation is mushrik. Yeah, this is like, so this is like, you know, how these people act. These people are ignorant. If you know Quran or Arabic, whatever, just stick to that. Okay, don't try to become also like a physicist. His reasoning is saying that, oh, okay, it says the energy is neither created nor destroyed. Because it says it's not created, it is shit. So if I tell you, like, you know, let's burn this, yeah? If I burn this, and then it just, you know, flames and this, that, so the heat is being dissipated, gone. Now, what the equation is saying, that this mass is being converted to energy. Okay? So, and let's say from energy, complete energy, we made something and we converted back to mass. So, do we have to call this has been created? Otherwise, we become mushrik. Do you see the mentality? This is sickness. And you need to seriously tell people not to like listen to these people or follow these sorts of people. And the other one is, like I will mention again, like I heard this, one of his videos on YouTube, like Zakir Naik. This guy, for example, quoting a verse from Surah Az-Zumar, verse 5, okay? And then saying that this verse is saying that the earth is spheroid, okay? And like, alhamdulillah, you know, I'm not like these people. I know the Quran by heart, and I know all the other like modes of the recitation. I said, okay, so the Hafiz Quran, I don't know that. I read Quran, and I read Quran all the time. Yeah, how many times like I finished the Quran? Thinking like, wow, amazing. Never came across this one. I saw people who are listening to Zakir Naik, they're like, oh yeah, like, you know, they're like getting, like, yeah, you know, because he has been asked question if the earth is flat or not, so he has to answer. But you cannot answer by, you know, just treating people, I don't know, I don't even have the words to say, because I'm really like upset about this sort of thing, because this is deceiving, okay? So let me first read the verse to you, and then I will take your question, because...
I just wanted to know for our non-Muslim viewers, what is a mushrik?
Mushrik is polytheist.
So idol worshipper? Or
yes, like
or associating
exactly,
partners.
Yeah, associating partners with God.
Oh, okay.
So, okay, so, and this is an example, like, this is an that's what we, like, seriously, I'm just... and then, like, okay, let's go to, like, Surah Az-Zumar. So it says, As-Sa'amu Bismillah. Surah Az-Zumar is, this is Surah, okay, verse 5, it says, خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the samawat and the earth, okay? بِالْحَقْ, in just proportions, like with the truth. يُكَوِّرُ اللَّيْلَ عَلَى النَّهَارِ وَيُكَوِّرُ النَّهَارَ عَلَى اللَّيْلِ. It is saying that like the night and the day, they follow one each other. Okay? This is like, I mean, if you go, let's say, you know, they just take, let's say this is like a sine x wave function, okay? So let's say it goes like this. So what this verse is saying, like, from here to here is, let's say, night. Then from here to here, okay, it is day. So as you can see, like, this is what we call, it's like a wave function. So just to simplify, like, I just wanted to show you this. Everyone knows this, it is simple, okay? So if you want to go, like, you know, as far as, like, because, you know, you want to prove that, you know, it is mathematically related, this, that, yeah? There you go. That's what you can say the most, okay? This guy is saying that this verse is talking about the shape of the earth. How come, like, I don't know, look, I couldn't find, I'm just asking you guys. As a mathematical physicist, yeah, I have no clue how he is relating this to the shape of the earth. Yes?
I think we try and say that, like, something like the night blends into the day and the day blends into the night. So this is what we observe.
Okay, listen, night and day, these are the concepts in, like, time-related concepts. It is related to the motion, yeah, of, like, heavenly bodies, etc. Or, like, atomic clocks, and then we measure, and then this, that. So night and day also, like, you can say, okay, concept, because, you know, it becomes like dark and then night. This has nothing to do with spatial dimensions, which is related to the shape or geometry. If you want to go as far as, like, you know, thinking, okay, so this is like related to time and time related to energy. Okay? Like, if you want to think, like, push it, you know, like, this Quran is not a book of science. You cannot, like, push it and pull it and, you know, make all sorts of modifications to come up with, because, you know, you want to just show that, yeah, it is, you know, this, that. So this is completely wrong. And we are, like, many people are doing this. And this verse, and then he also mentioned another verse. When I remember, I will tell you that. I think it was in Surah Al-Luqman. But anyway, so but the same verse is, yeah, I think, yeah, in Surah Al-Luqman, again, like, the word, like, yukawwiru layla is being used there. Like, day and night, they kind of, you know, follow one another or shift, okay? But like, as you can see, like, you know, I'm just here, like, I'm just being sarcastic by showing this. Because this is, like, simple. You cannot, like, you know, tell people, you know, look, I can explain, you know, this verse, because there's some sort of circular motion in the verse, yeah? Then I can explain it in sign X. You see, I know it. Do you know it? Huh? Yeah, I found this. This is sickness. So if you like, seriously, we have to just come to terms with ourselves first, like look at like who we are. And none of the Mufassirun back in the times, they did not come up with this stuff. Okay? And yes, go on.
So are you saying the classical exegetes?
Yes.
The Mufassirun, they never said that this verse means...
No! Mm. I checked Jalalain, I checked Qurtubi, I checked Ibn Kathir, okay? Like... I haven't checked actually Fakhr al-Razi, but I can say, because he's the more like in Tafsir al-Kabir, he talks about some of these stuff. But like again, the Mufassirun is Mufassirun, just like human being, like you and me, okay? So they may understand things in a different way. That like they do not represent Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we should look at the text, whatever is the text is saying, without any like modifications. We believe that like Quran can be understood by normal common people. Imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sending a verse for common people. It is simple. You know, if you just ask a shepherd there on top of a mountain, he will tell you that the earth is round. Okay? He doesn't need to be a mathematician or, you know, any kind of like scientist. Because when he looks at the open sky, okay, it is clear, like there's curvature, okay, in the, you can see it. So seafarers, you know, if you are like traveling on like a ocean or something, so you can again like, you know, observe these things. And the other thing is like this rationalized guy, he is saying that there were two mutually like exclusively like, it's unbelievable. He says there are two views basically in the 7th century about the shape of the earth. He goes like some people they believe the earth was flat and some people they believe the earth was like, you know, like a bowl or something. And then he says Muhammad believed that the earth was flat. And then he mentions these verses. Okay? There are many verses here. But like I will carry on from this verse.
This rationalizer guy. Mm-hmm. So you're saying there's basically Muslims who are not like exegetes, experts.
Yes, yeah.
So what's this rationalizer guy? Isn't he doing the same thing? Basically he's just saying, here's my commentary on Quran. I just made it up. I think, you know, Sama means flat ceiling. Mm-hmm. I insist, I don't have any proof in English language or Quran. It's same thing. Like,
yeah, okay, here's the thing. Let me show you this, like, properly, because this is important. Okay. You see, I can make it, like, you know, sign X from this verse, you see. So, okay, here's the thing. There's Quran here. Right? So you have here some Muslims. You have here non-Muslims. Okay? Now these Muslims, they're ignorant, but they think that they know something. Right? But they don't have limit, no limit. Brave. They are in bliss.
You mean like overconfident, right?
Yeah. They know it. Because, you know, because the congregation, because the audience, they're also ignorant. Okay? So everyone is... Because people nowadays, they come to these like conferences, like, yeah, this guy is good, like, yeah. You know, like in, for example, you see in some talks, you see this preacher starts talking and some people, they say, yeah, you nailed it, go on, brother, yeah. Like, you know,
starts
this attitude.
Allahu Akbar and
like, you know, the guy is like saying something, saying, yeah, God is great, Allahu Akbar, you know, yeah. Like, this is like, subhanAllah, what is this? This is sickness, seriously. It's just nothing here, like, it's unbelievable. I can't even find them. So this is like the project. I'm not like, you know, saying like this individual, that individual, this, that. But if I see that someone is making a mistake, okay, openly, and many people are getting confused because of that, I will name them. I'm not saying these people, you know, they are bad people, etc. What I'm saying is that these people, they have complete, like, lack of understanding, okay, in certain things. So you have to be aware of these individuals. Like, don't take anyone, like, yeah, this guy, everyone loves him, I love him too, okay? So first of all, there's like some, there should be some sort of, like, measure stick, okay? But if you do not know, then how are you going to measure? So then you have to also know. So that's why, like, you know, it is important. So you have these people here. So they just, you know, they translate, okay, translate Quran. So let's, okay, we say this is Quran now, okay. So these people, they translate. I would say, you know, they mistranslate. Because I'm going to show you some evidences. It is just unbelievable. You know, the amounts of, like, I checked some, like, translations in English and also in some other languages. Okay, it is crazy. You know the words. I don't know. It seemed, even I saw people. You know, they translated white as black. It's that bad. And then, you know, there are some, like, search engines. Like, you put a word and then they compare all the translations or something. It is craziness. Seriously, I'm telling you. If I was not a Muslim, yeah, as a scientist, if I read these translations, I would say, this Islam doesn't make sense. I would just move away from it. So now think about it. Why is this happening? Okay? And but it is our duty to, you know, show that, you know, these, they don't make sense. Nothing. So one of them is this, yeah? So these mistranslate. Okay? And then they make things up. Make things up. Like, I just made something up here. I just said, you know, sin X is in Surah Az-Zumar, verse 5. Yeah? So I can even, like, you know, make more things up. Because I know, you know, I've been trained in this. You know, how to make things up. And, like, I can even, like, look at a person and then just make things up about his shape. You know, just write a quadratic equation or something. So... taking these verses and making things up is easy for everyone. You can also do that, okay? And so that's what these people are. So, but the intention of these people, yeah, what is the intention? There might be two intentions. Maybe they want to say that they sincerely believe and they want to attract non-Muslims to become Muslim, okay? By doing what? Mistranslating, making things up, including lying. So, inshallah, you know, we will do lectures about, like, Usul al-Hadith. In Usul al-Hadith, we know that, like, back in the times, there were people. They had, like, schools. Okay, like colleges. And in these schools, they were fabricating hadith. They were fabricating the sayings of Prophet Muhammad to attract people to worship more. For example, they are saying that, oh, this time if you pray 100 units of prayer, yeah, you will be in paradise. And then they are calling it hadith. Now the guy is thinking 100 prayers of, like, you know, 100, wow, so I need to pray 100 units. And then, you know, they give the timing as well. They say, for example, between Maghrib and Isha. You know, between Maghrib and Isha, if you want to pray like 100 units, you have to just, like, seriously, I don't know, you have to be so quick. Like, bang, bang, ding, ding, like that kind of. But anyway, so somehow they do this, yeah? So my aim is, this is just an example, okay? I'm not saying this is a particular hadith, this, that. So they did these things in the past. And the enemies of Islam also did invent lies, okay? So the Muslims do that, yes. Why do they do that? Many reasons. We need to understand the human nature, okay? Humans are humans always. Whether Muslim, non-Muslim, this, that. But Islam gives you a guideline to become a good person, okay? And so if you are still, like, because you know your character is sometimes like it's embedded in you. You need to see your faults and change, see your faults change. So do you have this? And then you have non-Muslims, yeah? Again, like ignorant, okay? But like they think that they know everything, right? Arrogancy, pure arrogancy. Oh, by the way, you have arrogancy here as well. So don't, like, if I'm writing something here, definitely it is here as well, okay? So what happens here, these two, it's a battlefield. They battle, right? And in the between, they are like just normal beings. They are getting confused. They are like, what's this, what is happening? This guy is saying this, that guy is saying this. They are also ignorant, but at least they say that, yeah, I don't know. Okay? But these people, they claim like, you know, I'm a scholar, I'm this, that. By the way, I'm not saying like all of them, but at this day and age, most of them. Okay? I will give you one example, yeah? I have been interviewed by a mosque a couple of weeks ago. They asked me, okay, we want you to lead Taraweeh. Okay? And then the guy told me, can you recite something from Quran? I said, okay. And then I asked him, I recited, and then he said to me, oh, is that all? Yeah? Can you recite like some of it? And then he told me, I don't know how to read Quran. Yeah? Imagine, a guy is testing you how to recite, that if you are reciting correct, you know, with tajweed or not. And he doesn't know Quran, but he has lots of money, he owns the mosque. Uh-huh. So this guy. And I told him like, subhanAllah, you know, this is really ridiculous. I said to him like, bye-bye. And then he also said bye-bye anyway. But the funny thing is, the imam in that mosque, because I prayed there, you know what he was saying? He was saying to the congregation, you should get Bukhari and Muslim, buy them and read it to your kids so they can be good people. Again, this is sickness. Imagine, imam is saying this. This imam doesn't even know, yeah, what Bukhari and Muslim are. They're not like for laymen.
These are books of hadith, right?
Yes, they are books of hadith, yeah. But they are specifically compiled for certain academic people. They are not like compiled for laymen. There are books of hadith for laymen as well. Imagine like in these like compilation of hadith, it is talking about warfare, it is talking about some, you know, other stuff, and you are reading these to your kids, right? And the other thing is, you don't even know the commentary of this hadith, because it was causing lots of problems. So Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani wrote a commentary on this. So why did this great scholar write a commentary on Bukhari, if it was so easy for everybody? So anyway, but the Imam is saying this. So if a rich person, because of his richness but no knowledge, runs the mosque, you will get an imam like that. And many imams, I'm saying, are like this. Majority of them. They do not have knowledge. I have to say this. Okay? And then they just go around and talk about anything. They do not know when to stop. Also, like some irrelevant stuff. They have no clue, and there are lots of things going on behind the scenes. Like, everyone is like attacking Islam, this, that. You go to the mosque, they are talking about like a hadith which was like 1,000 years ago. It's completely irrelevant. Okay, look, we are dealing with these sort of things. This is important. And no one is doing their work, basically. So here, so they are like, it's a battlefield. So ignorant, pure arrogance. They want to deviate people. Okay? Deviate. This is their aim. People. And then they want to attack Islam. They think also that Quran is similar to Bible. So they always make comparisons. Quran, Bible, Quran, Bible. They have no clue that, like, what Quran is and what Bible is. And actually, there are no qualified people to teach them as well. Like, Muslims are so, like, they live in, like, utopia, completely just beyond this world, that they cannot even explain these guys, like, what this is, what that is. But also, most of these people, like, who are trying to, like, attack Islam, they are not sincere, okay? So, as you can see, this is happening. And so, here you have two extremes. And then in the middle, you have these people who are not extremes.
So are the non-Muslims also doing this? Because, like what you said about mistranslating, it sounds like rationalizers kind of doing that.
Yeah, of course. This mistranslation, make things up, lying, all of them. Here. Like, for example, Orientalists. Mm. Think about this. Like, what is the aim of these people? So, so this is all there. They don't know what these things are. And the other thing is, as I said, like, they cannot find anything wrong with the Quran. So they go to the translation. So they take the translation and then just make up things from that translation. Okay? Use a bit of, like, rhetoric to deceive people. If they cannot find anything with the translation, because in the translation you have just, they don't comment many things, because if you speak too much, you'll make mistakes, human being, yeah? So same thing, they go to this time, what? The commentaries of Quran. So in the commentaries, because the guy is writing lots of things, and then they are picking things up from there, right?
No, you're right. It's exactly what we see with evangelical Christians who attack Islam.
Exactly.
Exactly that pattern you said. They look for translation, usually they don't find it, and then they look at specifically Ibn Kathir, because
yes,
it's widespread.
Or Ibn Kathir or other, and again, not from the original Arabic, but from English translation. And then some of them also, they get help from Arabs.
Yeah, Arab Christians.
Okay, and then they take these words and then try to... But look, so Quran, so this is original, let's say. So this is a translation. And then this is commentary. Okay? So they are showing this to you as Quran. Okay? They are saying that this is Quran. And they are criticizing someone's words and then claiming that it is Quran. They are trying to deceive you. Yeah, you have to be clever. And then they are taking again this translation. Again, like, also the mistakes of Muslims as well. They don't know how to translate, right? And then, because you know, they are so busy to segregate Muslims into groups. Okay? This is what Muslims do nowadays. They just want to group themselves. Say, I am this, I am that. It's like, you know, I'm Manchester United, you are Manchester City. Yeah? So, exactly in the same manner, even they have, you know, stadiums and call them mosques. I'm serious. I'm not joking. Every group has a special mosque. Alright? Have you ever seen a stadium which is for all the football teams in the league? Everyone can go there. No, you cannot. So, but these people, that's why, you know, they say, hey, this is for this, this is for that, this is for that. Anyway, so, this is, look, like, you have to seriously understand this. They are showing the commentary as Quran, which is not Quran. They are showing the translation as Quran, which is not Quran. Yes?
But I think you're absolutely right, but the problem is also with Muslims, because Christians will say stuff like, for example, I've seen people like James White, they can't find problems with Quran, mm-hmm. as you say, exactly right, they go to the commentary, Ibn Kathir, and then Muslims feel that they have to defend everything Ibn Kathir said. Mm-hmm. So it's just like asymmetric warfare. So on one side, Christians are just defending Bible. No commentary of Bible, no hadith, no mm-hmm. narration, just Bible. But Muslims are defending Quran, all of hadith, sahih, everything, right? Mm-hmm. And like literally defending each one like, yeah, like it's truth. Mm-hmm. And then defending all commentaries line for line. So mm-hmm. like Ibn Kathir, he will say something like, but Ibn Kathir is the most authoritative, most authentic commentary. And then Muslims will say, oh, how can we go against that? It must, do you see, it's like...
Okay, let's say, now we need to understand, for example, the different types of tafsir and mufassirs. We have riwaya and diraya, two types of like tafsir. So, and also, in the tafsirs, when we look at like they, for example, they explain certain verses with hadith. So, not every mufassir takes the authentic hadith. Okay, they explain certain verses with weak hadith, even fabricated hadith, because these Quran exegetes, they were not muhaddith. So, not every mufassir is a muhaddith. Okay, so then they make mistakes and they have been criticized for this. And these like fabricated hadith also, you know, they have been noted in these books. But I mean, Muslims don't even read like Quran properly, let alone, you know, they're gonna like go one step further and then read, you know, all these works. Because they're so busy, you know, in making money or person the world and this, that, so whatever, you know, the aim is. But, so as you can see, so this is the problem, and both Muslims and non-Muslims, they are doing this. And so this rationalizer guy is one of them. And then he's even, you know, he doesn't even have the, he's not doing it, you know, to show people that, look, this is the truth. He's just mocking with people, mocking with the concepts, etc. But actually, he's mocking with himself. If you watch it carefully, and I will show it to you now in some examples, because I don't want to go through like everything that he says, because you know there are lots of things here that I need to deal with. Now, for, as I said, like for example, it goes like there were exclusively like mutual views. And the earth was flat and then sphere this there. First of all, like concept of spherical earth dates back to 6th century BC. Okay? Philosophically. And then even like I was reading somewhere, I forgot, but you can find this, you know, on Wikipedia and other sites, the references. Like in the 3rd century BC, they even like calculated mathematically, okay? So that the earth was a sphere. This, you know, it is a myth that, you know, they say, oh, in the 15th century, Christopher Columbus and this, that, blah, blah, they discovered that the earth was sphere, you know, at that time. Even if you watch, you know, QI, which is one of my favorite programs by Stephen Fry, if you watch that, they even tackled this issue. They said that this, like, flat earth thing is a myth. But this guy, because he wants to prove that, he has a point, so he says, yeah, in the 7th century, Muhammad was living in the desert and he believed in the flat earth. Wow. Unbelievable, yeah? Because he wants to make his point, because he's going to claim that the Quran says the earth is flat, yeah? So, first of all, we said there's not a single verse in the Quran which says the earth, the shape of the earth is flat. Okay? So, the other thing is what these people do, like even Muslims and non-Muslims, they take a verse out of context. Okay? It is called, the Quran has got 114 chapters, and each chapter tackles certain things. Yeah? For a reason it is called a chapter. Now, if I say, triangle, right? Let's say triangle, we are talking about mathematics now. This is one chapter, and then another one is circle. Yeah? So, these are different chapters. Okay? So if there are any relations, then you can mention them, but under this chapter. In order to understand, now would you go and look at triangle to understand the concepts of circle? No. What these people are doing, they're taking, this is an example. So I will carry on with this sort of MBI because it covers all of it. Because they take it out of context, so they cannot take all these verses together. Because verse 30, 31, 32, 33, they're all talking about one thing only. Okay? And before that, there's a build up to it. Suratul Anbiya starts with يَقْتَرَبَ لِلنَّاسِ حِسَابُهُمْ وَهُمْ فِي غَفْلَةٍ مَعْنَدُونَ. It's talking about this day of judgment is coming, and people are in deep heedlessness, and they are turning away from all the signs. Okay? So and then it talks about, look, this is amazing. In the second verse, it says clearly, مَا يَأْتِيهِمْ مِنْ ذِكْرٍ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ. When a word, when something comes from the Creator, مِنْ ذِكْرٍ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ مُحْدَثٍ إِلَّا اسْتَمَعُوهُ وَهُمْ يَلْعَبُونَ. You know what they do? They play by listening. They don't take it seriously. It's just, it's just the stories of previous nations kind of thing. And then on top it says, La hiyatan qulubuhum. Okay? This is talking about they take these words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as they mock with them. This rationalizer guy is exactly doing that. He's mocking with them. For example, he says oh Allah, chin up, and then good luck with your next book, kind of thing, right? This guy doesn't even make sense. First he believes that Muhammad wrote it, and then he says Allah, write your next book. He's all over the place. Because, he's not sincere. So, and many people like that out there. Even they call themselves Christians, I don't even believe that they are Christians. Because they have certain concepts. Even we have Muslims, they are not even Muslims. But we cannot call everyone you are Muslim this day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. Okay? But if someone is deliberately taking the verses out of context, trying to deceive people, okay? Just read the whole Quran, you will see the characteristics. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, during the time of Prophet Muhammad the companions knew the hypocrites, but they could not tell them that you're a hypocrite. Do you understand? They can see the characteristics. So that's why, we cannot say, that person or this person, this. But everyone has to look at himself or herself, okay, and work for himself. So in this, it starts with, as I told you, in Suratul Anbiya, with how these people, when a verse comes to them, they start mocking with the verse. Exactly, this guy is doing that. So he's saying, Quran says Quran is flat. Earth is flat. That's what Quran says. This is their mentality. And then they use this word called Madda. Okay, in this verse. So, madda, it's because in the verse it says, in the next verse, وَجَعْنَا فِي الْأَرْضِ رَوَاسِيَ أَن تَمِيدَ بِهِمْ وَجَعْنَا فِيهَا فِجَاجًا سُبْرَ لَعَنَّهُمْ يَهْتَدُونَ. So, okay, so in this verse, but in the other verse, it says like, وَهُوَ الَّذِي مَدَّ الْأَرْضَ. So, مَدَّ الْأَرْضَ, like, مَدَّ has lots of meanings. One of the meaning, for example, if there's a periodical rise of tide, yeah, and due to lunar or solar attraction, that is called مَدَّ, okay? And also, مَدَّ means like lengthening, extending, making something longer than normal or larger than normal. Also, it has the meaning of like basata, which means like elongate or unfold or unroll, make something smooth, make something even. Okay. It also means like to furnish. Okay, like zawadabi. Or it also has the meaning of like sail, which means like flow, rushing stream of water. Okay, lava or something. So as you can see, it has like many meanings, okay? Like make it even, okay? Make it like flat, right? Yes?
Hang on, is this the verse he's saying is says the earth is flat?
Yeah, he's using the word madda, like وَهُوَ الَّذِي مَدَّ الْأَرْضَ, for example. This is like 13 colon 3, okay? In this verse, let me, it is Surah Al-Hijj. I think, let me see, and then I will just confirm it, let me see. Okay, yeah, so one is in فِسَمَاءَ بُرُوجَ مُزَيْنَانِينَ وَحَفْنَا مِنْشُونَ. Okay, وَالْأَرْضَ مَدَدْنَاهَا. Okay, so here in Surah Al-Hijr, verse 19, it says وَالْأَرْضَ مَدَدْنَاهَا. So مَدَدَ, like مَدَدْنَاهَا, same with like مَدَّ. It says we make the earth like even, like the surface even, or we extended it, okay? We made it like smooth, or we made it like larger or longer than normal. So it can take all these meanings, okay? So we should like, but I will explain what this means, yeah? And then in another verse, it is in Surah Ar-Ra'd also, okay? Surah Ar-Ra'd verse, 1, 2, okay, 3. وَهُوَ الَّذِي مَدَّ الْأَرْضَ. Again, like مَدَّ, مَدَدْنَا. They all come from the same root. And they mean, as I explained, they have like lots of meanings. So, does it mean, now I'm asking you, like it says, here, look, it's clear, yeah? It's so clear. This guy is just talking nonsense. So, that's what I want to show you. So, first of all, it talks about this word called al, okay? So I'm writing it in Latin because not everyone can read Arabic. Is that fine?
Including him, including the rationalizer, I think.
Oh, yeah, okay. So al, and then we have word madda, okay? Madda or madada, okay? Like, madad, okay. Because that, the na means is just something different. It means like us or we did the like, okay, madda, madada. So al is this earth, okay, that we stand on. Al, like this earth that you stand on, we stressed it, or we made it even, we made it uniform. So
spread.
Yeah, spread. Like, okay? So now, the simple question, does this give you anything about the whole shape of the earth?
Well, no. Are you saying basically it means the earth you stand on, not planet earth?
No, no. Like the earth is, L is...
Ground.
Huh?
Ground.
Yeah, like the ground that like we stand, like it is basically, L is the opposite of ceiling.
Okay.
So okay?
You can't take it as planet Earth.
Yes, so like, okay, L and Sama, you know, Sama, okay, look, Sama and L, okay, they are the opposites of each other. It is in the same manner that like how, you know, Layl and Nahar. Like Layl is night, Nahar is day. So sama and aut, in the same way, like they are opposites of each other. Like the reference point here is the human being. So if I am staying here, the ground that I stand on is out, and then the ceiling above me is sama. Okay, and so like this sama is, that's why like it in one verse it's been explained as saqfan mahfuza. So saqfan is like, again, like ceiling, canopy, okay, and mahfuza is protected. Okay, so sama is that, and al is opposite of. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that I made this al, yeah, like stressed it and like, you know, made it comfortable in a way, made it like, make the conditions of this earth that you stand on livable, manageable for life. Now this is my addition. But where do I get this from? I get this from by reading the whole page. Do you understand? Now taking this, this is not even, I say like 5% of that particular verse. Do you understand? How can you, let's say, you know, I'm just telling you, I said, do you? Do you? Do you what? Do you drive? Do you? Exactly. So this guy takes do and you, yeah? And then he goes, uh-huh, do. Right. You see? This, you know what this is? This means like command. Do it. So yes, this is do. You think, what is going on? Do you understand? So this is the way, you know, these people, they're because they're sick in their mentality, because they want to, their aim is to deceive people. Okay? It is not enough for themselves, like already deceived, but they want to take other people with them as well. So it is same with everyone. You know, even same with, you know, these Muslims who mistranslate and this, that they don't want to accept the truth. And or they don't want to like back down and say that, you know what, actually you're right. You know, I need to look at myself. Or say that, may Allah bless this person who showed me my mistake. Okay, because with that mistake you can go to like other mistakes and then your life will be ruined. But yet, when someone like corrects us this, that, and then you take it like, I need to defend, you know. How can you correct me? Who do you think you are? Let me tell you something, you like, I believe, seriously, amongst you guys, I might be like, seriously, I certainly believe that I'm worst, like one of the worst guys. Probably I'm thinking so, like, you know, worthless, at the point that like, you guys will, you know, be forgiven by Allah. But, you know, I have lots of, you know, mistakes and sins, only Allah knows, okay? But you know, this is a different issue. You know, when it comes to like, you know, making stuff up about the verse and this, that, this is something else, man. Huh? This is like, you need to understand this. So, again, so this is the mentality. So this is the question. So the question is, so from less, you know, I'm just assuming, like, because we are copying that guy, yeah, rationalizer, because he rationalized. So out and madda, taking just these two words, and then saying, uh-huh, found something, I found something. The guy doesn't even know Arabic, let alone, like, you know, any other sciences that I already mentioned. You need to know lots of things to like, you know, to be able to, yeah, I think he doesn't need to know anything because he's not even looking at the Arabic, he's just looking at the English. So he's like, yeah, so everything is like, from the start, is like, this is, you know, the wars of, you know, they say like wars of titans.
Hmm.
Like, in terms of like ignorance. Yeah? They are really like titans. if, yeah, so you can go. So this is like, and so as you can see, just I just told you what these mean. And that told you this. Okay? Now let's carry on with the next one. So here.
So can I ask how
yes?
is there any classical commentator or rationalizer could have gone to and said, actually no, I'm saying what Ibn Kathir said. I didn't do my own homework. I got it from those guys.
Okay, so first of all, Ibn Kathir and all the rest, yeah, when they translate these things, I checked them. They used the synonyms words. In other words, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for example, talks about madda. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also talks about like tharashna, like tharasha. Allah talks about like mihada, dahaha, okay? All these, they have like very close, like they can be considered as synonyms. And these scholars, they're considering these words as like synonyms. For example, when he explains madda, it says a, like basataha, because like basata or something, or a, you know, dahaha, same like meaning. But I want to say this. I saw in Tafsir al-Jalalain for the surah Nazi'at, and Nazi'at verse 30. وَالْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ دَحَاهَا. Okay? The دَحَاهَا, Imam Suyuti was explaining that as دَحَاهَا and also كَيْفَ سُطِحَتْ, like سُطِحَا. So he's saying that the earth was made like stretched. And then it says that some people, they say that it is like a ball, like kurra, okay? And then he's saying that to believe in the kurra is not one of the tenets of Islamic belief. So if someone believes that the earth is round or the flat, yeah, that is not gonna affect that person in any way, like in the eyes of Allah. Like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not punish the person because you believed in you know, the geometry of the universe or the earth was this, or you are wrong. So he was saying that this is the claim, since Quran clearly states that we made it stretch, we made it like, you know, elongated. It is better to accept just these meanings and leave it there. But these people, they look at like, they again like this commentary of Imam Shaykh, and they said, that's it, you see, he's against the Qur'an. Yeah, he's against the shape, which is like a ball. So he says that that's it. Like, you see, he believes in flat universe. So, this is the thing. So, okay, the other thing is, as I said, like, we need to read the whole verse, and the verse does not tell us in any way or shape or form that the shape of the earth, yeah, is a spherical or anything like that. So, and this guy is just making things up. And the other thing is, like, I haven't even, like, read the... If I read, you know, these verses together, you will easily see that it's not talking about like a flat earth or anything like that. It's saying, look, can I stretch this?
Mm.
If I put a, look, in engineering, also in physics, you know that like if you put a force,
deform it, yeah.
Yeah, you can deform this, right? So this deformation can happen, right? And then it can happen like through sideways, right? Or lengthwise, widthwise, okay? So this can happen. So in the same way, the earth change is formation, okay? So the earth is not in the same formation it was at the, you know, beginning when it was forming, even after, like, you know, let's say 100 million years after its formation, right? Earth grew, okay? The moon also, like, changed its structure, and then it moved away from the Earth, okay? And by the way, all these things are like theories. No one has seen these things, right? No one has like made any experiences, so experiments went there, etc. These are theories. And the other thing is the formation of the atmosphere. So again, completely changed. Like back in the days, at the it was like completely toxic and hostile, very hot. Okay, so then you cannot like live in these hostile conditions. So you didn't like the Earth did not have the atmosphere that we have right now. So that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he is talking about we made the earth like stretch. Earth, the surface of the earth was not like this. It was so hostile. You would not be able to survive on the planet. So that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is trying to say that, look, you know, this earth was really hostile. Okay, and it wasn't like smooth or, you know, when we say like, you know, smooth, we are talking about, let's say, you know, just take the size of the earth and shrink it to the size of, like, say, basketball or football, yeah? Then this crust, the crust of the earth, would be thinner than a sheet of paper in terms of, like, smoothness and also the thickness, okay? So this is what we are talking about. So you can see that, like, the earth went through lots of, deformations, and restructuring, etc. And then came to a form that now it is habitable by complex living beings like us. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly, like in this verse, like stating that first talking about like how the earth and the sama, they were together, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala separated them and then created water. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, then we made the, you know, surface. Because so the surface, we have like lots of, let's talk about like plate tectonics. We have like a divergent, okay, and convergent movements, right? Okay, convergent movements. So divergent movement, for example, let's say, you know, you have this plate, and then you have another plate here. When these plates, when they move, so it creates like this is divergence, and then there's a ridge opening here, and then from here magma comes, goes up. And then here, you know, lava build up, etc., and then form a new, like, land. But at the same time, because, you know, this is from lava, lots of gas, okay, is spewing, going up, gushing out, yeah? So this gas is going up and in the air as well. So, and then it is becoming part of the atmosphere. So, and through convergent, like plates, so they come together, so one goes up, like, so here, this sort of like continental or oceanic or continental plates, they create mountains, right, here, okay, and these plates, they move, right, they move through convection, because there's liquid here, and so the currents, convection currents, they move these plates. And we have a theory called like Pangaea theory, and like all these continents, they were one at one point and then they separate. So we have another like Pangaea, I think in the future, this is again like theory, predicted to happen, it's called Pangaea, like ultimate Pangaea. So then all these continents, they will come together and rejoin, okay? And so, and now the question is, like, as you can see, through divergent, you get like new landforms. Also, like, we have like lots of lava and this, you know, they're going up and then becoming part of the atmosphere. And then we have like convergent, the mountains are being formed, etc. Yeah? And these mountains, there are lots of goodness for people. Like, people like make their like livelihood Even like back in the days, like in the Quran there are verses. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about certain people who make houses in these mountains. Strong houses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. So when you like, you know, like when you know like that verse, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is saying after, you know, like made the earth like straight, like because you guys can like live freely, because if it wasn't like properly stretched, imagine, okay, but when we say like stretched, here's the thing. If you look at the asteroids, they look like peanuts. They don't look like balls or like, you know, like anything smooth. So how come like all these like peanut shaped things, and then they come together and then they make an earth which is like spheroid, and a bit like, so we call it like flattened spheroid actually, because through the poles, so, or like oblate. So how come it took this shape? Through internal gravity, okay? It took that shape. So it wasn't in that shape. So the shape changed. So all these things happen for a reason. And then not only the shape changed, like the structure, the form changed, and then through time, the atmosphere built nicely for people. Like, we didn't have oxygen, for example. Where did we get oxygen? Like ozone layer. So we had things called like stromatites, and they had like cyanobacteria on them. So cyanobacteria, they use like light energy, and then they produce oxygen as a byproduct. And then this oxygen, it goes up, and then, you know, slowly build up and form the ozone layer. And ozone layer protects us from what?
UV
light rays, etc. And then we have like later, so we have mesosphere. So mesosphere protects us from what? Like meteorites, okay? And all these, like, so the atmosphere protects us. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the verse, so as-sama saqatan mahfuza. So we made this, you know, sama as like protection, like protective ceiling for you. And now you are telling me that, like, oh, it says, and then this guy is saying, it says saqfa, it means canopy. That means it is flat. Because they believe that the earth is flat, according to this verse, they must believe that this canopy is flat too. You see, it has nothing to do whatsoever. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that, look, this is not all by chance. If it was chance, then it will be as like in the early young earth, it will be completely, the atmosphere will be full of like sulfuric acid, or, you know, lots of like carbon dioxide and other stuff, and hot, hostile. No one, like no complex organism would live. So gradually, like, you know, through this cyanobacteria, and then, you know, water, like before then, like with meteorites, lots of water came, lots of processes happened. You know, scientists, if you listen to them, they will tell you that the earth, yeah, just worked out to be perfect for life. Just. Yeah? So, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, look, it is not just, it has been planned properly. And in Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in many verses, clearly states this. Like, you know, وَالشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ حُسْبَانًا. Okay? Like, you know, it's all like measured. إِنَّا كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقْنَا بِقَدَرٍ. Yeah, we created, yeah, everything with a measure. There's measure in everything. It is not randomness. It is not like by chance. Yes?
So it sounds like from what you're saying, people like the rationalizer are just being like waste men and just taking things out of context.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
Also some Muslims are doing that.
Yes, some Muslims are doing that.
Could you, for our benefit, give us that verse in its context, like the whole page, and how it should be understood?
Okay,
because I think people benefit from seeing like how, because this is like basically deception, isn't it?
Yeah, it
and
is,
people
yeah.
do this, I believe you were saying, with the verses of jihad as well, so-called.
Many, unbelievable. They like, for example, There's a verse, as Allah says, قَاتِلُوا الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ in Surah Tawbah. It says in the verse, yeah, that like fight, you know, against people who do not believe, you know, in God, and like fight with, you know, Ahli Kitab, like, you know, Christian Jews, this, that. They don't even say what this verse is for, okay? This verse is specifically talking about like people who attack you first, who oppresses you, okay? And then against these people, you need to fight.
And which they would know if they'd read. So they've clearly read the whole page, but they're just deceiving people.
Exactly. Not only the whole page, but also like, you know, these people who translate.
Hmm.
Or the person who knows the context of that chapter would know that.
Hmm.
Okay? So the whole chapter is about like defending Muslims. So like, you know, under what circumstances you can defend. So what happens to like, let's say, POWs? Okay? So how would you treat them? All that sort of stuff. But they just read because it says fight, yeah, against these. That's it. I found the word fight. That's it. I have to, that means Muslims, they will just, you know, fight. No, Muslims fight only if they are being oppressed.
Which the chapter makes clear.
Exactly. But it makes it clear.
So it's the same problem as this, isn't it? Like some, yeah, like...
So that's why I'm saying, like, all these translations, etc., it's just told, you know, imagine here, yeah, this is so important, and they don't even make, like, side comments to make it clear. So, let me talk about also some other thing.
But can you give us the verse in...
I will now, but, like, I need to make something clear, like, also, like, this people, like Rationalizer, they do not understand, or they don't have concept. I don't think he studied like a differential geometry or manifolds or topology. Because if he studied these things, even, I mean, he doesn't even probably need to study this. If he was a pilot, or if he knew some sort of like, you know, how planes like, you know, go around the globe, etc., he would know that there are two things in the geometry of like a thing. Like when we analyze the geometry, we look at two things. We look at like local coordinates and global coordinates. So we have two like coordinate, main coordinate systems. So in locally, the earth is flat. If someone says the opposite, then that person, you know, because this guy say, what did he wrote something, he was saying, because, you know, people are so ignorant, so they don't know anything, and so because of their ignorance, they will not realize things, and it will lead to absurdity. They say that common sense and ignorance equals absurdity. Me, for his benefit, that equation is false, okay? Common sense plus absurd, like plus ignorance do not lead absurdity. You need to be a charlatan as well, okay? So absurdity multiplied by charlatan.
Mm-hmm.
So you can mock with people. Imagine, yeah, someone is ignorant, he thinks he knows everything, and then he's joking with others that I know things, but actually he's fooling himself. So he's not even aware of the fact that like in geometry, you know, seriously, if you study, go just type on Google, you know, topology, manifolds, yeah, differential geometry, GPS, go just read a bit about GPS, for example. You will see locally and globally. For example, when we study this universe, we have like local coordinates. So we treat the certain parts, you know, of the universe as locally flat. Okay? Same thing. If you take a patch from this Earth, then you treat that patch as locally flat. Okay? So, but globally, it is spheroid. So we live on the Earth, and we live on like small scales. Okay, so there's because of that, like we consider things like if we are the reference point, to us, the earth is flat. You cannot say, for example, to your, like, I don't know, somebody, let's say, you know, you're going to sit down somewhere. Okay, let's say, you know, I wanted someone to bring a carpet to this room. Yeah? Imagine, I said to you guys, can you please bring me a carpet which will fit this room, yeah? And then you said to me, uh-huh, the earth is spheroid. I need to bring a spheroid-like shape carpet. And then you brought it like this. And then I asked you, like, what is this? And then you are saying that, because the earth is spheroid, so it will fit nicely here. This is, like, stupid, okay? So that's why, like, you know, we live in a flat, like, surface to us as a reference point. And in geometry, we treat these, like, surfaces as locally flat. There's a difference. So here, you know, let's say this. So you take a patch from here, okay? And then you deal with this patch, and we say this patch, yeah, is flat, okay? So it is the same thing. Like, for example, look, if you take something from here, right, this is flat, right? And then if there's a bug living here, you cannot tell this bug, you know, actually, you know, this host that you are living on is not flat. It's, no, it's a different shape. He will just tell you, like, are you crazy or something? So that's why, like, as I told you, if this guy was sincere, even if he was sincere, I don't know if he knew or studied, like, differential geometry, and he will know this, you know, taking a patch and treating, you know, certain manifolds locally, etc. That's why, for example, we have Euclidean spatial dimensions, which is like denoted as like this, okay? So this means, like, when you take, you know, x, y, z coordinates, let's take it, okay? Say, so you have here, okay? I'm sure lots of people saw this, okay? This is z, okay? Let's, I don't know, it doesn't matter. So call this x, this is y. So this goes like that, goes like that. Oh, the other thing, this guy also denies that there's up and down as well. He thinks that because Muslims think that the earth is flat, so that's why you have up. And then he shows, like, the earth is spheroid, and, like, if this is up, this is up as well.
Okay. Can you elaborate on that? Because I saw his video, and that was a gaffe, basically. I don't think he has a good understanding.
He has no understanding. It's like,
I think you're confused, non-Muslims, actually, because, like, he doesn't really understand about, like, geometry either.
No, nothing. No geometry. That doesn't even have a sense of direction. And he's making, like, YouTube videos. Now, the thing is, look, this is up, okay? This is down, okay? So this is, like, forward. Have you heard of something called, like, the rule of thumb?
Hmm.
I mean, if you study, like, electromagnetism, this, that, they will always tell you, like, you know, if you hold it like this, you know, this is going forward, yeah. This is going... So, this is also, like, an XYZ, so a forward, so backward, so left-right kind of thing, okay? So, this, let's say this is left-right, but, okay, so our point is this up and down, okay? So now, if I ask you guys, do we have the concept of up and down? Like, do we have up? Like, do we go upstairs? Can we go downstairs? Do we use these things?
Well, according to a rationalizer, we're on a sphere, so there's no such thing as up and down, right?
Yeah, yes, because he thinks that he's a big giant, like, you know, I don't know what he thinks of himself, but...
He's, like, comparable in size to the universe, maybe?
Yeah, it is like... So this is sickness. It's just... seriously, I'm even... I didn't even want to do this, like, talk and talk about this guy, because it's, like, no science... I don't know, it's just... This guy doesn't know anything. Anyway, so these are like two, like three complementary, like orthogonal heads. These are like orthogonal heads. And then, and this is what we call like egocentric coordinates. Okay, so it's a relative direction. So this is like, you know, left, right, okay, forward, backward, up and down. So, the thing is like, we need to also understand, again, like translational invariance. You need to study these things to understand the coordinates and how these things are made up. If you don't have a like proper like sense of coordination, as this guy doesn't. And the other thing is, for example, we say like gravity pull the objects down. Yeah? So whatever is the object trying to like, you know, move away from the gravity is going upwards. Like, I have studied from, seriously, like primary school till like a PhD, all I dealt with things like gravity up, down, all the time. So according to his mentality, this doesn't exist on this spherical realm. Okay, so this is another thing. And then also he is extremely confused and he's trying to like confuse others as well. So this is all I can see about that. But he also like I think mentioned things like, because there's a verse which says in Surah Al-Ra'd it talks about like the pillars that you cannot see. Okay, this is another one. He says, for example, okay, so I mentioned that. So Allahu alladhi rafa'a as-samawati bighayri 'amadin tarawnaha. So rafa'a means to raise something or to go up, yeah? So rafa'a as-samawati, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised the heavens, okay? Or the canopies, okay? Bighayri 'amadin tarawnaha. Now it's saying that the pillars that you cannot see. Okay? So, as I told you, like, this is very common. So, if I told you, let's say, you know, you look up the sky, yeah, you see objects, or you see, let's say, you know, atmosphere, you're thinking, like, how it is, you know, possible that these objects, they're just there. And then you see, like, darkness. You don't see any, like, because we think, like, whenever, like, we build things here, we always build pillars, right? I mean, I haven't seen a single like house which is just in the air. All right. So the question is this: like, just for normal people, not people like Rationalizer, because he's super intelligent. So because that's why like he thinks like he's criticizing this verse. Because the verse clearly is saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised the canopies or the heavens, yeah. Without the, like, the pillars that you cannot see, basically. What is this referring to? Pillars that you cannot see. Right?
So, I think he, using his genius brain, probably thinks it's an invisible pillar.
Exactly. So, that's what, like, you know, this is, like, again, sickness. So, I mean, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing here that, you know, look, you know, I can make things, I don't need pillars, this, I can make things with anything. So can we see, for example, gravitational force? Can we see electromagnetic, like, force itself? You cannot see these things, but they are forces. Okay? So, now, because, you know, I have studied gravity, this, that. Although, scientists don't even know what gravity is. We don't know, seriously. Like space-time, we don't know what space-time, how it looks like, we have no clue, okay? Same thing with gravity. We even have a, like, you know, hypothetical particle, like, we believe that, you know, gravity is because of gravitons. Because, you know, all the other magnetic, like, electromagnetic force and weak force, they have particles. So, why not gravity, okay? But we haven't found it yet. So, but we believe that, you know, because we measured, you know, we did experiments, such a force exists. So, me, when I read this verse, immediately it just pops into my mind. that is talking about, you know, because the gravity is not like a pillars kind of that we can see. It is, in a way, like you can call it like invisible pillar, okay? Because at the end of the day, the pillar is there, you know, to hold that thing in this, or like, you know, place. So gravity also does that. Like, the reason that we are all like in this orbit and the moon is because of this, right?
But yeah, according to these people, basically, Quran can't use any kind of figurative language, or you just start criticizing it. So if it says pillars, it has to be like an actual pillar.
Yes, yeah, rubbish.
If it says flat, it means flat. Mm-hmm. And if it says up or down, so Quran can't use geometry. Quran can't use figurative language. So Quran has to be some, basically, they should write it themselves. And then say, yeah, you see.
Yeah, that's what he does. He says, for example, he says, oh, why does it say raised up? It should said far away. It made it far away.
What far away? What was raised up?
These stars or because he's first saying, oh, if the Quran is referring to the stars as heavens, then they are made, you know, in far away distances. So this guy doesn't even know what cosmology is all about. Not all stars made up like in far away, because we have to know that the universe has been accelerating and expanding. So they were all like next to one another, right? And then the expansion started, and then they were already like made, do you understand? Or the birth already happened. And then they started like, okay, some of them, they are still being made, but not all of them. So if you want to be really accurate, he's again flopping. Like, you know, all the time. So, you cannot like generalize everything. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because referring to us, okay, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not referring to like other, like some giants and this, that who live up, you know, outside the earth and who can see the earth kind of thing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is referring to simple, yeah, beings who live in their own world, like flat surface. We live on a flat surface. You cannot like you know what? Look, whenever you just, you know, drive your car, for example, if you're on like steep hill, you say like, oh my goodness, I'm now on a steep hill. Because normally, you go most of the time on flat surface. And like, for example, Arabs or Bedouins, people who cross the deserts, who live in the deserts, they are most of the time going through flat surface. Okay? So, and Quran is referring to these people. Now imagine, what would be the point of Allah saying, rather than وَالْأَرْضَ مَدَدْنَاهَا, yeah? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying now, I made the earth spherical. What's the point of this? I made the earth spherical. Then I would say, oh my goodness, you made my life difficult. Do you understand? Why didn't you make it like stay so I can walk like freely, nicely? Like, you see, his mentality is just very flawed. Because the earth is spherical, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is referring to the point that, look, in this spherical earth, there are lots of forces, like complexities. And upon these, like, you know, like magma and everything, and it was so hostile, everything, yeah? And I made it so habitable. Like, you can live, you can accommodate yourself with ease. You don't need to worry about anything. Let me tell you, for example, now that some people say, oh, you know, there are earthquakes, there are this, there are that, yeah? There is darkness, there is light. Everything is like created in pairs. There is steadiness, there will be also shaking. These things are here to like explain to human beings certain facts. Which is about the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? So, and also become grateful that, like, you know, I calculated, was it like a couple of days ago, like, you know, I think 500,000 earthquakes happen in a year on this planet. and only 0.02% of it causes damage. Did you know that? You see, so from this, what we can say is, wow, this is amazing. Yeah, this is amazing. And the other thing is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also threatens people who go against him with earthquakes. Yeah? So, just read the Quran, yeah, with sincerity, then you will understand. So here, because it says, بِغَيْرِ عَمَدٍ تَرَوْنَهَا, so he, again, like, we explain this, yeah? Now, I'm not saying that this verse is talking about gravity, but because as a scientist and as a thinker, it just comes to my mind. I cannot say to you that this verse, yeah, is talking about gravity. And then you'll tell me, no, no, it's not talking about gravity. No, you ignorant, you don't know, I'm a scholar, it's talking about gravity. Then show me the word here of gravity or anything related to that. For example, gravity has certain characteristics. Yeah? There's no such thing, but just one, like, clue kind of thing. Then keep it to yourself. And if you talk to somebody, like, who is, like, level-headed, then you can share it with that person. But don't say that, you know, this verse, there's gravity, we found it. Yeah. Bring it. This is stupidity. This is deviating from the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay?
So, Hafiz Mahmud, are you saying there's not anything in the Quran which blatantly says you live on a flat earth?
No,
like a disc earth, a disc
No. This is seriously. Okay, the other thing I was saying, you know this Anbiya, Surah Al-Anbiya, verse 30, people saying that this verse is about Big Bang.
Oh, the heavens and the earth were joined together.
Yeah, this is stupid. Because, okay, first of all, the verse starts with أَوَلَمْ يَرَى الَّذِينَ. We said, you know, يَرَى, two meanings. You should see it and you should contemplate about it. If you bring me one person here, who's going to explain, bring anyone, even you can, like, you know, I will give you my everything. Bring everyone who can explain it to me how the Big Bang started. Anyone? No. This is a theory. We have many other theories like Big Bang theory. Hence, we have quantum gravity and the string theory, for example, alternative theory. We are trying to understand how this thing happened. And because, you know, you read it in some science magazine or this, that, and then in some other books, you are saying that's it. So, okay, tell me, how did it start? If this verse is telling you the start of Big Bang, how did it start?
So you're addressing this to Muslims who claim that Big Bang...
Muslims, not anyone. This is like, you know, stupidity. I have seen this in many places. They're saying, okay, yara, look, I'm telling you, look, I explain it here, yeah? Yara, to see, and also to contemplate. You cannot even contemplate. How do you contemplate? Do you know the word singularity? Huh? Big Bang started with singularity. Do you know what singularity is? No one knows. Because all the physical laws break down. Now, by you saying that, you know, this verse is talking about Big Bang, what are you talking about? First of all, it says yara, see or contemplate. Okay, so the visible universe that we see, I mean, what, seriously? Are you talking about W map? You know those like islands of like temperature on
cosmic
background, background radiation. So what are you talking about? So anyways, these people imagine like even scientists don't know how, like, you know, what singularity space-time is. And these people, they're respected, like eminent, like professors. It doesn't matter whether they are atheists or Muslims, it doesn't matter. They are scientists. And they have been thinking about this like for a long time. And then now you came and you said, oh, it is in this verse. Why? Because I read it somewhere on Google. You don't even, like, you know, this, as I told you, this guy, like Bilal Phillips, E=mc² is shirk. The guy doesn't even know what that equation is. How can you talk about it, man? That's what I'm saying, it's sickness. So same thing, كَفَرُوا أَنَّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. So, كَانَتَا رَتْقًا فَفَتَقْنَاهُمَا. They were one, and then we separated. And then it says clearly, look, immediately after that, وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيٍّ. Immediately after that, it says we created everything from water, and then it says, don't you, like, are you not going to believe?
Every living thing.
Yeah, every living thing. So from, yeah, every living thing from water, so, yeah, so then, so you were at the Big Bang, boom, water came. Unbelievable, seriously. Look, I have studied like cosmology, I even like, you know, wrote a research paper about like the space-time, like black holes, which is related to like black Big Bang theory, in essence, like string theory. Never like I have seen a drop of water, okay, after Big Bang, or any like clue about that. It's just. Anyway, so this is like, okay, let's talk, this is, okay, so immediately after that, so it talks about, you know, Samawat al, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, then, you know, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala separated the al from Sama, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stressed the earth that you stand on, like, you know, the surface that you stand on. Hold on a minute, you're telling me, at the Big Bang, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the earth and then Sama'a, and then water, and then made the, what? Earth like stretch, yeah? Let me tell you something. If someone says this, this is against science. Because we know that the water started on after the formation of the earth. When the earth started formating, and then the meteorites came, etc. And then, you know, after like a while, the water started coming down the earth. If you say the Big Bang happened under water, and then we made the earth's surface like flat, and then we put the mountains. So, Rawasiya and Tamida became. This is another one. So like Rawasiya means, it's like, you know, like lofty, like formidable mountains, like mighty mountains. You cannot like easily shake them. This is what it means. It doesn't mean that like they cannot be affected by the movement of tectonic plates or the earthquakes, etc. It means if you are living on a mountain, yeah, in the same way, if you are living on earth, yeah, it like you can live there. The conditions are hospitable, as well as there are lots of like benefits of these mountains. In like change of the weather, for example, in Andes, in Argentina. Like lots of warm and cold clouds, they come and they meet, and they produce lots of like thunderstorm, lightning, etc. If these things happened on a flat area, where like people live, it would cause like devastating effects. But these mountains there, they meet there, and the mountains like trap these cloud movements there. And most of this, you know, lightning, etc., happens in these mountains. Okay? So in a way, they are useful for everything. Even like, you know, wind movements, clouds, in so climate change. Lots of people are living in mountains. Especially like back in the days. But nowadays, like, maybe more people are living in the cities. Or flat surfaces. But like Quran is also talking about, you know, those people who used to like live in mountains, and they made really strong, you know, houses in mountains. Like for example, I went to Turkey, a city, I forgot the name. There were like, you know, houses built inside the mountains. Inside. Unbelievable. It's like, it's not like, you know, 1-2. It's like, imagine like whole like city of people. They build like houses inside one. So they've been living there. And so why? Because they think these are like formidable places. It is not like, because you know, if you build a house on a like flat surface, let's say there is sand, or even if it's a sandy or something, even a small like earthquake will just demolish it. Or like, you know, some sort of tornado, this, that. But if it is like part of the mountain, you know, it's attached in. It's hard. It's like, in a way, like it's like a cave. So caves are the, like, for example, you know, best places to hide, isn't it? Like, from like dangers, this, that. So you go into a cave, that's it. Even like you go down underground, for example, you know, in the Second World War when Germans attacked, etc. Yeah? So these are like, you know, same thing. So these people, they lived in certain areas. So you need to understand the whole like Quran and what sort of stories Quran examples was given, and then these verses. So now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about not saying that, you know, like the mountains will not be shaken by the movements of earth, etc. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly says in like 3-4 other verses that actually mountains will be moved, like the clouds move. Because mountains are like a part of these tectonic plates. And we said tectonic plates move through what? These convections. Mountains, so that means with the tectonic plates they move. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this in the Quran. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that in these verses, this is also another one, like three verses, one of them is Surah An-Naml. So tamurru marra sahab, they will be moved like the clouds move. Okay, and then but like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is referring to the day of judgment, which is the end of the time. Okay, like I don't know whether big crunch or big rip, whatever, you know, is gonna happen. We are talking about completely like how the beginning the formation of earth at the beginning was hostile, unbelievable. So similar like circumstances, these like mountains will be turned into dust, like rubbles. Okay, we don't know the conditions. So ask a scientist, maybe he can explain it to you. And so the thing is, and then they take this, these verses, and they're saying that, look, this verse is saying mountains moving like you know, clouds. And just a second, and then first of all, these three verses, if you look at them, all of them talk about day of judgment. All of them. You cannot like take them and then say that, yeah, this, that. Let's say, you know, we take them. Yes, they are moving. They are moving with the tectonic plates. The mountains, they are moving, yeah, with the tectonic plates. And this tectonic plate movements, as we said, is related to what? Convection, current convections. Also, clouds are moving. Clouds are moving also with convection. And also winds, mainly. But like, so, just to read about, let's say, your cyclones. So, all these things, they are related. So you cannot say that. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is not a geography book. It's not saying like, you know, you saw mountains moving. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that, look, you see these formidable mountains? They will be crushed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that, you know, how mighty He is. How, you know, this day is going to be really tough. Okay? And saying that exactly, you know, you see these clouds moving, we will move them. Okay? So if this is the aim, like showing that, you know, just understand the message, right? Yes?
So, going back to what you were saying before, is the idea, you know what you said, that people say that the mountains do move and Quran says mountains don't move. Is that another allegation against
No, Quran doesn't say mountains don't move. Hmm. What does it say?
Like what you were addressing before?
Yeah, Quran says, for example, وَالْجِبَالَ أَوْتَادَ. Like, let's say this is in Surah Al-Nada, okay? So, again, like, we need to read what is coming before, what is coming after. Like, for example, As-Salaam Bismillah, it says, أَلَمْ نَجْعَلِ الْأَرْضَ مِهَادَ. Like, did we not, like, made the earth, like, mihada, same meaning as, you know, madadna, you know, stretched, but mihada is like a place where you can live, you know, like, it's again, like,
habitable.
Like, you know, like a flat surface, okay.
But
yes.
Who said that the Quran is wrong because the mountains do move?
Okay, now it's coming. And then, so it says, so he's taught Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talk about, look, we made the earth, like, smooth, yeah, for you. And then it says, وَالْجِبَالِ أَوْتَادًا. And then we put the mountains like pegs, like anchors.
Hmm.
Okay? So now, وَخَلَقْنَاكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا. Okay, and then talks about, like, you know, we created the... you in pairs. وَجَعَلْنَا نَوْمَكُمْ سُبَاتًا وَجَعَلْنَا اللَّيْلَ لِبَاسًا وَجَعَلْنَا النَّهَارَ مَعَاشًا. So it talks about, like, you know, your sleep and then the night and then the day, and then talking about, like, وَأَنزَلْنَا مِنَ الْمُعْصِرَاتِ مَاءً ثَجَّاجًا, how the water, you know, is coming and then it's beneficial for you. And then talking about لِنُخْرِجَ بِهِ حَبًّا وَنَبَاتًا, then, you know, you grow your seeds and plants and this, that, like, and like we bring it out, like, from the, okay? So, you see, there's a context here, okay? So, in like, mentioning everything, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says mountains. So, we, they're, like, you know, pegged, which means they're, like, you know how, what is a peg? So you, like, a peg, for example, has two parts. One part is down, like a root, and the other one is up. It's like anchor. You anchor something, like a ship. You anchor. And then, so you rely on that thing, right? So same thing. So mountains are as pegs. Like, I'm thinking, why do you, like, make it, like, you know, just put and, like, understanding, saying that, oh, now that means mountains are fixed. Okay? So, let me ask you something. Let's say this is okay. This is a board, and then if I nail this here, like a peg, yeah. Okay, put it here. This is a surface, and I'll put it here, right? And then this went down. Okay, so now this is the root. This is top, right? So, and then I said, I created, you know, this, and then I put mountains like a peg there. So how can I say that, no, that's it, you know what, it says that the mountains are fixed, yeah, and this is against science. How is this against science?
Who said that? That sounds dumb.
No, that's what I'm saying, like, people that are saying this. First of all, mountains, it says, like, mountains are there so that people... do not, like, you know, they're, like, you know, lofty structures, and people who live on them would rely on the mountains, or it would not shake You know, the people, like for example, let's say imagine a flat surface or plate, it moves, okay? It's moving. So then you would move on this, people who would live there. So if you, let's say, you know, put a mountain here, and then people live now around this mountain or top of the mountain, right? So they're benefiting from the mountain, etc. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is clearly saying that, look, I put these mountains like pegs there, right? They are there, you know, for your benefit. Like they are not going somewhere, so you need to follow kind of thing, right? Mm-hmm. So they are just there, right? So then make benefit out of it. And also they are reliable things. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying you can rely on the mountains. You know, in what way? So you can do like agriculture, okay? You can you know, use the woods or the forests, you know. I don't know, like many benefits of mountains for human beings. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says that, like, it would not also, like, if you lived on them or around them, it would not shake you. Do you understand? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says they are like fixed. Like, it's not gonna be like, for example, if you live in a house and then imagine like this earthquake happening all the time. So you would not live in that kind of confinement. You would just go somewhere which is stable. Same way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, look, these mountains are reliable. You can live on them. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is using the word rawasi, okay, for these mountains. So, and rawasi, it means like, like lofty, okay, like formidable mountains. But these people that say, no, look, Quran is saying that mountains are fixed. And so it is not fixed.
So Quran doesn't say that.
Quran doesn't say that.
Are these like genius guys like...
genius guys and all that sort of people. And Quran even says the opposite of that.
That they will move.
They will move. And the other thing is, they are going and looking at the commentaries again. And then they're coming up with the things like, oh, okay, does it move or does it not move, etc. And so as we said, like for example here, you know, when we said like أَلَمْ نَجْعَلِ الْأَرْضَ مِهَادًا, so that mihad is same like basata or like madad, like, you know, to make it level, like land, okay, so also firash, also again like in another verse, firasha, like resting place, you know, like a bed. Or you can say like a carpet.
Mm.
What's wrong with that? Carpet means, you know what we use carpets for? Because the floor is a bit like strong or not suitable to sit on, etc. So you put the carpet, so it is more like, then you can sit. Clear, like, you know, this is how it is being used. Back in these places. So the function of the carpet is not like to make the surface flat.
Mm.
And then also the carpet takes the form of whatever you put it on. If you put the carpet on a spherical ball, it's gonna look like sphere, right? So. And carpet is not, like, it doesn't, like, it's just unbelievable. You know, there's no even need to, like, refute this claim. It's that bad. Mm. So the function of carpet is just, you know, it is, like, fluffy, yeah? You sit on it, okay? It's like, it's comfortable, alright? Because if you remove the carpet, it's like, you know, now, stone and this, there, so it's, like, hard. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, look, this earth that like you stand on the surface, we made it like carpet, so you can managed to live there because it was really hostile, it was bad, right? So same thing with like mihada, same me, like, you know, we made it like leveled. And even like in, if you look at in the Arabic dictionary, it talks about like mustawi, yeah? Which means make it leveled, make it uniform, okay? So that you can live there. And the carpet analogy is in the same manner, you know, carpet. It doesn't say like, you know, carpet with like nails on it or something.
I think it's just xenophobic, isn't it, basically? You see a carpet. So you want to take the meaning of flatness from that because you have a xenophobic idea which isn't correct in the first place, that people in the past used to believe the earth was flat, and you want to show that, yeah, these guys are flat earthers, they're stupid. You see, that's what he's after, the rationalizer, really.
Yes.
Like, because carpet, as you say, it takes the shape of whatever you put it on. A primary purpose of a carpet is to make something comfortable, not flat, you know. Like, quite stupid.
Yeah, and so the other thing is, as we mentioned, like, you know, we need to look at like local geometry of things. So, like about this carpet thing, so we said like, for example, the curvature, local geometry talks about the curvature of, for example, if you're talking about universe, the curvature of universe, observable, this is local geometry. The global geometry, we are talking about like topology of universe as a whole. And so the measurement of this is not in our ability, okay? So, when we are talking about like local geometry, so like spatial, yeah, like curvature. So we have like possible local geometries. For example, as I mentioned, like Euclidean geometry, which is a flat geometry. If we did not know about Euclidean geometry, we wouldn't have like, you know, this technology right now. We wouldn't be able, because these steps that we have to go through and we have to understand. And and we calculate things according to Euclidean geometry, okay? And then also we have like, Euclidean geometry has a curvature. What is the curvature of Euclidean geometry? Zero, which means it's not curved. So then we can say, literally, it doesn't have curvature, so it's flat. So if we talk about, let's say, you know, a three-dimensional spherical, that's a structure, we have a curvature. Now the curvature is what? Positive. And then if you are talking about like hyperbolic like structures, then the curvature is negative. So I think this makes things clear, like, you know, local geometry and global geometry and how we deal with things. So not everyone is looking at the earth or living outside. Do you understand? Like, so, yeah.
Before you move on, you're talking about the mountains as pegs. What do you say to Muslims who use the argument that Muslims say the mountains are pegs and it stops the earth from shaking, and this is a proof, you know, like scientific miracle? Some people use that. I think some of the people you mentioned, they say that this is one of the scientific miracles of Quran. Have you come across that?
I just laugh at these people. You know, they are trying to make the Quran like a science book, and which is, when the Quran mentions specifically that, you know, there will be people, they will take certain verses and then change, like, you know, give the verses a different meaning. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, these people, they have sickness in their hearts. Okay? So, and seriously, people should look at themselves and then do like anything like this.
So is there anything in science which says that mountains stop the earth from moving, or does Quran say mountains stop the earth from
First of all, like, look, from what I know, the plates are moving, and the mountains, like in terms of like these convergent boundary-like movements. So mainly the mountains are made from, they're like folded mountains. I'm not talking about like volcanoes mainly, but like the Himalayas. And so these mountains, they do like have movements, but like so small with the like continent movement. Like continents, like they move like zero to, I think between 0 to 10 centimeters a year or something like that. Okay. Like for example, you know this Pacific, like North American, continent and Pacific, the San Andreas Fault there. So, in the future, for example, because the Pacific continent moves faster, so the, like let's say you know there's a city here, so because it moves, so in the future, like let's say there's a city here. Let's say, you know, okay, let me give you this example. So, you know, let's say Bristol is here, okay, and then Manchester here, yeah? Let's say they're moving. So in the future, they will be just neighboring, like cities kind of thing. So in the same manner, they move. You cannot deny this. And there's a verse in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَفِي الْأَرْضِ قِطَعٌ مُتَجَاوِرَاتٌ. Qita' means, these like land segments, like continents. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَفِي الْأَرْضِ, on the earth, on the surface, قِطَعٌ مُتَجَاوِرَاتٌ, these neighboring land segments, they move. So, and then if these mountains are moving as well, they are moving, but their movement is so negligible compared to the lifespan of human beings, compared to the lives, like, you know, around that we live, etc. So here the central point is human being. That's why these people, you know, they're like deceiving people. Because they are deviating from the life of human beings. Because we need to understand what is related to us.
So the reference point, the Quran.
Reference point, the Quran is using human beings. So that's why, like, we need to look. Okay, so yes, to us, mountains are like pegs. They are there. Like tomorrow, you go there, the mountain is still there. 50 years later, you go there, still there. Right? 100 years later, still there. Go. But if you live 100 million years. Then that mountain may move a bit. Do you understand? Have you heard or have you seen anyone living that long? Exactly. So this is the point. So what these people are doing, they're mixing this geological like life spans, times, with a certain human being's individual lifespan, and then comparing it. It's just absurd. It's just, you know, this is a joke. Like, so... and the Muslims again saying, like, what are you trying to do? Take the message. The message tells you this. Because, you know, they're like, you know, you can think deeply about this thing. You know, like, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, created us in certain proportions, created these mountains in certain proportions. For example, in another verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that, who do you think you are? Are you, like, loftier than the mountains? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is comparing you to the mountains. What does that mean? Now, can I say that? Oh, look at this. Allah is comparing a mountain with a human being. Scientific error. Okay? And then another Muslim is going to come and try to prove that. Take the height. If we enlarge a human being, you know, with the height of mountain, and then, yeah, there's this... Do you understand? So it's all stupidity. There's no need for these things. The message of Quran is clear. There's one God, Prophet Muhammad is the last messenger. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to protect this Quran. Okay? And then don't deviate from the middle path. As you can see, many people are not following the middle path. So this is the message. So that's why, like, that's how we should understand. And this is, as I told you, like, it is sickness and we need to deal with this. But also the other thing is, for example, this guy is saying, وَإِذَا الْأَرْضُ مُدَّتْ. There's another verse, yeah, in Surah Al-Inshiqaq. He's saying that, oh, again, this describes as like, you know, stretching and expanding out, etc. Now he's taking another verse, but this verse specifically talking about need, like day of judgment, where things are going to be like destroyed, like mountains, everything is like the rumble, it's chaos, okay? And he's taking this verse and then with his logic, thinking it like, you know, oh, okay, we're talking about today's world. Yeah?
Oh, flat earth again.
Yeah, yeah.
So why is he so keen to show that we said the earth is flat? Well, what's his, like,
I don't know.
Fetish for that.
I have no clue, yeah? So it says like this time, for example, okay. So this time he's talking about their judgment. So he doesn't even have understanding of what this verse is relating to, etc. Yeah? So he's just talking rubbish. And... the other thing is that we need to understand that the earth keeps like rejuvenating itself. Okay? The only thing, I mean, all you, do you know Mrs. Nerg or something? I remember like, you know, when I was teaching like GCSE or Key Stage or something, there's this concept of, you know, for something living, they have to have like seven characteristics.
Oh right, yeah, yeah.
So and there are like folders like Mrs. Nerg or something like that. Okay, so it's like movement, okay, like respiration, sensitivity, and then nutrients, excretion, and reproduction, growth. And the earth only doesn't have this one, reproduction. In a way, earth is alive, okay? And it's been alive and it's been changing its form, etc. And the Quran is being sent for like a long period of time. And earth is still changing. It's moving around, etc. And because these people, they are very narrow-minded. They want the Quran to be written in a very like textual format, like, you know, that's it, you know, it's a restricted time frame kind of thing. This shows also, you know, they are ignorant again. Muslims, non-Muslims, put them all in the same boat who are trying to like mistranslating or trying to take a verse and saying that, yeah, this is, you know, this, that, etc. And then they are like after fame or anything else, whatever, you know, for that reason. And some of them, they are doing it sincerely. But, you know, I mean, an ignorant person can be sincere, yeah? Mm-hmm. So, it doesn't matter like whether it will change that in any way or form. And also, the other thing is like this guy is taking like some quotes from Bible and then comparing it with Quran, saying that like Quran copied from Bible or something like that. It's like,
yeah, this is another fetish.
Yeah, and also like, for example, it says like in Bible it says the roots of the mountains. Yeah?
Yeah.
In Quran, there's not a single verse which talks about roots of mountains.
I think he botched that. I saw a video like that and he's just taking like, the Bible's referring to like, you know, the base of a mountain, mm-hmm. like people hang around, like, you know, like you can't climb it.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah,
no,
Nazim's again.
So it says, yeah, in Bible, you know, the quote that he was showing, it says the roots of mountains. In Quran, there's no such a thing.
Mm.
Because, you know, some Muslims, whatever, or some people who said that, you know, because it says pegs and then it's roots and this, that. Again, like someone is like, you know, making a comment and then he is trying to refute his comment away from Quran and then saying that, look, this is Quran.
Is it in a commentary? Is it...
Yes, like, no, this guy's own commentary.
Oh.
Right. Even not in like the tafsirs, you cannot see the roots and this stuff. Do you understand?
Mm-hmm.
So in the tafsir, all you have to you see is like thawabit or the thabit. Okay?
What does that mean, sorry?
Thabit is like a firm.
Hmm.
Immovable. With respect to human beings.
Hmm.
Do you understand? You are the reference point. You have up. You can look up. Okay? So, yeah, you also look down. You are the reference point. So, the gravity pulls you what?
Down.
Down. Yeah? So, this guy saying that, oh my goodness.
It's like me saying relative to the universe, there's no up or down or something, right? Just like weird.
Yeah, yeah, like, yeah, I mean, it's... Yeah, if you think like, you don't even know. Oh, the other thing is, you know these people, what are they saying? You know, Big Bang or, what are they saying? Some people claim that, like, they can see, you know, the funny thing is, those people who claim Big Bang or the heavens and the earth were together and blah blah, yeah. Like, you know, 96% of the universe is dark, no clue, only 4% is visible, and these visible things are like these stars. And the Quran mentions, look, Quran says, we put the stars there as like lamps and adornments. We beautified this, you know, the first heaven kind of thing. And the funny thing is, like, I mean, we have no knowledge, we lack of lots of knowledge. And then, like, as a scientist, I accept this and I cannot say more. These people who haven't studied these things, right? And then they talk about science and they make up things, they create the universe and then they destroy it and then they take the verse and fit it. It's like a jigsaw puzzle to them. This shows that, you know, the seriousness is gone. Like, you know, people, they don't understand what, like, Quran is talking about. They're really away from it. As I told you, like, everyone is selfish and they're thinking, yeah, yeah, me, and this, that. The other thing is, like, he makes this assumption that if Earth is flat, then sky is flat too. Okay? Again, like, stupid thing. And as we said, like, you know, we can get, like, canopies like this. And you know the funny thing is, like, you can even, like, read it in some texts. They will explain the atmosphere as, like, stretching. Stretching. So, if the atmosphere is stretching, the earth, the surface is also stretching, okay? Because the atmosphere is around the earth. Does that make sense to you? So, the surface also stretches. So, we have like things called like elasticity. Okay, plasticity and brittle movements. I mean, deformation of this step. So things stretch, shrink, all the time. And so the continents, the earth, like, I don't know, like, this guy can fool people who are ignorant, but, you know, there's no exemption, or there's no, like, excuse for being ignorant. You have to sit down and read and think, contemplate. And so as we said, like, you know, it was made, like, extended so that we can accommodate ourselves. Yeah? So which makes sense. And then, so as we said, like, you know, he also denies up and down, etc. The other thing is, like, yes, the atmosphere has been raised up because at the formation there was no atmosphere, right? And then because Earth's surface was molten, okay, for many million years. Then eventually you cooled, and then, you know, thin crust formed, etc. And then volcanoes, they kept like erupting, releasing carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, nitrogen, and steam. And then the steam, like, condensed. And then the oceans, etc. So, and then, you know, cyanobacteria and photosynthesis. So It's a kind of formation. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is referring to this, like, no, we made a protective ceiling for you. And then these guys, they're taking these, you know, sama and then bringing it to the Big Bang. In Big Bang there was no sama. How can you have sama while you have nothing? And then something is being created, and if you look at the, you know, the, I mean, we have no clue, but the first bits of Big Bang. So if you look at it, it's like all like plasma, and like even after then, and like we have nothing, and then, you know, things happening. Like no concept of like ceiling, basically.
Or, this is Muslims you're talking about.
Yeah, Muslims. It's like it's sad.
Would it help Muslims to understand what the Quran means by heavens and earth? Because I think people are confused, isn't it? Like, some people take heavens to mean atmosphere, some people take it to mean sky, some people
okay,
take it to mean universe.
Okay, so this is, we need to do another talk for this, because this is a really dull concept. Because things that we need to understand, that sana is used in the Quran for mu'annath and mudhakkar, which means like it is used as a masculine and feminine in certain verses. For example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِذَا السَّمَاءٌ فَطَرَتْ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, here it is used as mu'annath. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, السَّمَاءُ مُنْفَطِرٌ بِهِ, here it is used as mudhakkar, which is like masculine. So we need to understand why these like, that the sama is used for masculine or feminine, okay? And whether like one is related to the atmosphere, or whether the other one is related to, you know, the outer like ceilings or like skies. So we need to understand this. And the other thing is like, for example, earth and like a moon. So these are used also like in feminine form. Why? So, you know, these things are important. So, but this is part of, as I said, like Arabic language and also ilm al-balagha. And so, because you know, there's a verse, for example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allahu alladhi sab'a samawati wa min al-ardi mithlahum. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created seven like sama ceilings, and also mithlahum, and also seven earth. So what does it mean? Right, so we need to, so we can do a talk about these things, but like today's talk was about like to show show the serious mistakes of these people, whether non-Muslim, Muslim, and no one is nowadays like taking anything seriously. Everyone is like me, you know, and then they are creating confusion, and sincere Muslims, they are getting affected. Or sincere non-Muslims who want, maybe they want to learn, they are getting affected. And these imams and this, that, to me, in my eyes, you know, I exclude the ones that who are doing the true work, yeah? But most of them, they are jokers. Seriously, they are not, like, these, like, translations are, seriously, some of the translations I came across, I was like, thinking, what is this? If I, like, let me show, like, I will give you one example, yeah? And, for example, here, there's this verse. It's talking about Sangam Sunnah, إِذَا الشَّمْسُ كُوِّرَتْ. Okay? So, كُوِّرَتْ is like, you know, we use like in Surah Zumar, same word. It's like,
Koyo.
Hmm?
Koyo.
That, coiled. So what is coiling?
Round.
Okay, round. Okay, so what, can you say like this is coiling? This is coiling? Huh?
Yeah.
Okay, so kubirat, it means, yeah, similar to this. Let's say, you know, you, like you have this starting point, and then it is, in a way, taking like a more mass around it. It's like, you know how you make snowmen? Snowmen?
Or snowball.
Snowball, yeah. So the top of snowman.
Spiral.
So, what you do is you push it,
roll it,
and then it gathers what? Mass, and then it becomes. So إِذَا الشَّمْسُ كُبْرَى, this is talking about the end of the day, the doomsday, this verse. So it says إِذَا الشَّمْسُ, the sun, كُبْرَت, when it becomes like كُبْرَت. So this is saying that the sun, let's say this size, is gonna go like this. Okay? Now, because I studied like astrophysics, I know that this is the last phase of sun, which is called the red, so it becomes like red giant. So it starts like, expanding, and then it, Mercury and the Earth and all that sort of stuff, so it swallows all that. But when it is happening, when this is happening, you know how bright it is now? Yeah, at this stage it is turning to a like red giant, so that brightness is going down to like redness. Okay, so then the wavelengths are also being like longer rather than short wavelengths. So this is إِذَا الشَّمْسُ كُبْرَت. Okay? Now, for example, in some of the translations I saw, for example, they say about like, let's say, coiling, but they also say its light is gone. Right? The light doesn't go. Do you understand? So, this is a mistake.
You mean the Quran doesn't say the light goes?
No.
It just says coiling.
Yeah, it says like a coiling in this, like, it is gathering like kind of like mass and expanding kind of thing.
Can you name the translation?
Or like, like a turban.
Mm.
So,
yeah.
You just do, so it's like that
getting
sort
bigger,
of like a thing. So, and the other thing is, and then in the next verse it says, but this is talking about like the doomsday, yeah? So the end of time. And then the other one is, وَإِذَا النُّجُومُ كَدَرَتْ. Okay, وَإِذَا النُّجُومُ كَدَرَتْ. So, like the stars in كَدَرَتْ. In كَدَرَتْ means, they become hazy. Like, you see how like stars are bright now. So that means at that time, like they will look like hazy, or their light will be going down kind of thing. You know, this means that like they will emit in longer wavelengths. Because I studied, again, astrophysics, so I know that because of the expansion of the space-time, and this is what you call like Doppler effect, so then you will see these lights being emitted in longer wavelength, and they are getting like dimmer and dimmer, okay, moving far away. So this in Kedara, that's the meaning. It's like, the stars look like hazy. Right? This is the meaning. But because I studied it, and I can make this connection, and it makes sense. But I cannot say that, this verse is talking about Doppler effect. Do you understand? But if you, so that's why I'm saying studying is very important. Then you understand, how things make sense. So again, here it says in the translation, it says when the stars fell. Do you understand?
So hazy is being translated as falling.
Yes.
But not good.
Not good at all. And so the. Like there are also
which is the translation book, by the way?
Oh, okay, so he like إِذَا الْجِبَالُ سُيِّرَتْ, so the mountains are moved. But this is, look, moving of mountains we are talking about. This is talking about what? They have judgment, like, you know, that they completely, not now, alright?
Oh no, I mean, which translation is it?
But just, you know, I'm telling you, almost all the English translations have these.
Oh, okay.
Okay? Oh, like, just check them, you'll see whatever you see, like falling, etc. And then you know what some Muslims do? Yeah, we know there are fallen stars. They don't even know that these things called fallen stars are not stars at all.
I mean meteorites and stuff.
Yeah. You see how, like, things are getting mixed up?
So I think you'll need a whole talk about this heavenly bodies in Quran, isn't it? Because it's causing a lot of confusion.
It is, it is really terrible. And
Can you, just going back before you finish, can you clarify, are you saying there are no scientific miracles in the Quran? Or are you, you know, like, because you're trying to make the point, I think, that Muslims are abusing this argument.
No, there are miracles in Quran. Mm. The Quran is itself is a miracle if you know how to read it.
Mm.
But what I'm trying to say is people are taking the verses and making, because they have a prior knowledge, they are trying to fit it into, as if, like, for example, I just told you here, yeah? I said this way that nujumun kadara, because, you know, they look hazy, right? And then we know that, like, universe is expanding and accelerating. And these objects, stars, they are going away. And we know that, like, the further they go, they emit red, like, longer wavelengths. And the ones, like, which are closer to us, like a shorter wavelength.
Oh, like red shift and stuff.
Yes,
yeah.
So this is like, you know, you say like Doppler effect, isn't it? Now, if I say this verse is definitely talking about Doppler effect, this is wrong. Okay? What you can do is, yeah, for example, you can translate it as it is, and then you can make a comment. You say that current research or findings show that in the future, like where, like, you know, this verse is referring to, there's a possibility of this is happening. Current observations prove this. And then you will put, let's say, you know, the Arabic word with references, saying that, you know, this means really this.
So in an academic way.
Yes, not like
waste man.
That's it, you know, Doppler effect is in the Quran. Yeah, let's do a talk about it. Miracle! Doppler effect is in the Quran. So then I ask you a question. Yeah? So before Doppler effect was found, so wasn't this a miracle? What was it then? Like, don't make things up. Like, you know, when you learn something, share it with the, like, humbleness. And don't, like, don't say, Allah Akbar, you know, this fanaticism.
And most of the people making these kind of comments are not leaders in their field, or they're not experts in science.
And the other thing is, like, you know, it is really terrible to just say, like, Quranic verses, like, oh, you know, chapter this, verse this, chapter this, verse this, yeah? And then the guys don't, like, subhanAllah, I don't remember a single, like, you know, talk. Because I have attended many great scholars' congregation, they would, like, when they mention a verse, yeah, they would mention it with, you know, utter, like, humbleness, and then they would explain certain things, and then they would just be silent. Do you understand? Nowadays, it became like a logbook. So, let me see if I can mention like a couple of things before we finish, inshallah. Let me see. said, like, for example, like, I mean, I have been on mountains, I climbed mountains, okay? And I never felt that I had been, like, shaken or this, that. There are really firm structures. My, like, I have relatives who live on mountains, okay? And I live there, perfectly habitable, strong places, okay? So, as we said, like, if you, even if you look at, like, Jalalain, for example, when it mentions, it says, وَأَلْقَى فِي الْأَرْضِ رَوَاسِيَ أَن تَمِيدَ بِكُمْ. So it says, like, the people of these mountains, they do not, like, get shaken. It is true. It is not like, you know, something flimsy, like the mountains, where, like, you are there and, like, always shaking you and this there. So, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about, you know, and people are also awed by mountains when they become amazing, tall, you know, this, that, everything. You know, so you should see these things in this sense, not like, you know, making it like a geography book and then trying to explain it with all sort of like rubbish. And then, let me see. Oh yeah, the other one is, there's a verse in Surah Al-Anbiya, again, which talks about, like, again, Day of Judgment. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, in Surah Al-Anbiya, let me tell you the number of the verse. So it is 104. So it says, يَوْمَ نَطْوِ السَّمَاءَ كَطَيِّ السِّجِلِّ لِلْكُتُبِ. So it's saying that we will, like, we will fold, okay, the sky, like the way that we fold like a scroll. Again, this is just like an example. This is talking about the Day of Judgment. No one has any clue about what's going to happen, how things are going to fall and this, that. You can make as much computer simulations as you want. Okay, so this is talking about, like, that day specifically, whether it is going to be like big crunch or big rip. Okay, so we don't know. So, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, like, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this verse is showing that He is so mighty that you see the sky and the skies, etc., yeah? They are just nothing compared to Him. That He's gonna just destroy them like a piece of paper, like a scroll, yeah? So, and the other thing is, He's talking about, like, this folding, this, that. There's an analogy here. If you know the Arabic language, you would understand, like, and ilm al-balagha is important here as well, like, what this means, like, when it says, كَطَيِّ السِّجِلِّ لِلْكُتُبِ. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كَمَا بَدَأْنَا أَوَّلَ خَلْقٍ نُعِيدُ. So it's gonna, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is gonna start the creation again after destroying it from the beginning. Like, according to current understanding, we say that, yeah, okay, the most reliable theory, we have Big Bang. So how, you know, this evolution of stars and the universe started, yeah, you can think, like, in that sense. So, and the other thing is, he says, like, you know, this folding. So the word here, like, matwi, okay, it means, like, bending, twisting, creasing. It has different, like, you know, meanings. Or tucking, okay? And so it doesn't... also, like, sigil means, like, a record or roll, like a scroll or register. Like, kutub is something like you compile, like, collect. So, kertayi is, like, curved, like a line or bending. So it doesn't, like, you know, it's not like as they claim that, yeah, it's just this, and then it's going to be like this.
Who claims that? Is this...
Rationalizer and some other guys. So it says like, so God is going to make it like this, and then it's going to start it recreating again. So if you make it something like this, it's not destroyed completely, is it? It's just a change the shape, right? So then you cannot like recreate this again, because it's already, I mean, come on. For recreation, you mean that you need to completely destroy it, and then, so if you take the, you know, literal analogy, so from here we can see that these people, not only literalists, they're also like, they're living off in cuckoo land, that's all I can say. They have no clue about like the language, no science, nothing. And so that's, I would say. Oh yeah, the other thing is like another like verse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, رَفَعَ سَمْكَهَا فَسَوَّاهَا. So it means like, سَمْك is again like similar to سَف. So it means like ceiling, inner surface of top part of a room or something like that, okay? So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised up, you know, سَمْكَهَا فَسَوَّاهَا. And then, you know, raising this sky up and then making it like evenly uniform. So the message is clear. It's talking about, it's not talking about like or giving lectures about geography, physics, this, that, but it is talking about how things were not like good or at the beginning, and then later on, you know, gradually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made things perfect for human beings to live. Okay, and then we make it like habitable. So, I say, inshallah, I hope people can understand how dangerous, you know, this world we are living in, not because of the natural like conditions, but because of human beings. How they can deceive people? It doesn't matter, Muslim, non-Muslim, this, that. People, they deceive others. And so for that reason, like, we have to be careful. And if you do not know anything, we should not like make up things. Okay, so then we should not like lie about especially these verses. So inshallah, I hope this is a good message like for everyone. And thank you so much for attending this talk. JazakAllah khair.